I have a confession to make. I don't like sports. I said it. Actually, let me rephrase that. I don't like most sports, and therefore, I don't really like sports games. Well, most sports games. Like, for example, a simple baseball simulator. No, thanks. How about you replace players' bats with things like a mace, a pickaxe, or a witch's broom? Have ridiculous names and crazy abilities like flying outfielders and tornado pitchers. Well, yeah, that sounds awesome. Play through a regular basketball season with regular basketball players? Eh. How about a 10-minute two-on-two basketball game with flaming dunks, turbo players, and a cheeky announcer?
Welcome to NBA Jam!
NBA Jam's story begins, as so many do, in the arcade. Released by Midway in 1993, it was a massive success, reportedly earning profits upwards of $1.1 billion. Acclaim, who ended up porting most of Midway's arcade games to the home market, did exactly that, releasing NBA Jam March 4th, 1994, on Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, and Game Gear, and then to the Game Boy and Sega CD later that same year. NBA Jam was immediately followed up by Tournament Edition, which was released on many of the same platforms. After that though, NBA Jam never really quite recaptured the same lightning. After a long run through the 16 and 32-bit eras with a number of misfires and straying pretty far from its roots, NBA Jam has actually seen a return to form with a reboot in 2010, even coming back to its original title, NBA Jam. Aside from the arcade, we're going to be sticking to the home console ports here. There's not really much to say about the handheld versions other than it's NBA Jam on a handheld. That's it. Now, as these are famously two-player games, I'm gonna need a famous second player, right?
You wouldn't know famous if somebody pointed at someone famous and said, "That guy's famous!" Oh, I'll play with you, though.
Yeah, Dreamcast, your insults are still terrible. And that'd be cool of you, but other than the one holding you up, you don't have any hands, so...
Well, yeah, but...
Plus, NBA Jam wasn't on the Dreamcast. Do you know anything about it?
Well, no, but...
Okay, then. You can see how that might be a problem.
Can I just watch?
No, you have to explain the game and talk about the game.
Come on!
No.
Come on!
No. Your ports are incompatible! Oh, God. I'm sorry, Dreamcast. I didn't mean that.
That was incredibly cruel and hurtful. You could actually be a basketball player, you know that? You know why?
Oh, maybe you're getting better with your insults, but I can see the punchline coming from a mile away. I do not play with
you're my ball. Jerk!
Joe!
Oh, that was magnificent. I'm really glad I got here when I did.
You heard that, huh?
Yeah, I did. But I'm confused. Was he saying that all basketball players are jerks?
Don't listen to him. He's just an inanimate object that's somehow possessed of human speech. Wanna, I don't know, play NBA Jam and never mention this again?
Yeah, sure. Sure, let's do this.
NBA Jam Arcade, released in 1993 by Midway, is actually a spiritual successor of sorts to an earlier Midway game you may have heard of called Arch Rivals, released in 1989. Arch Rivals created the fundamentals that NBA Jam would go on to develop further and ultimately perfect.
NBA Jam is a very straightforward game. Score more points than the opposing team and you win. You know, like regular basketball. That's it. You'll run up and down the court with the joystick and have buttons to shoot and pass with, which while on defense double as steal and block. NBA Jam, though, is famous for its third button, Turbo, which cranks the dial to 11, making your players run faster, pass quicker, perform super dunks, and throw elbows.
That is really where this game goes from a good game to a great game. It doesn't take itself too seriously. Jam completely leaves out any fouls and foul shots so you can freely throw those elbows. Not to mention that if you make three baskets in a row, you're on fire and you'll shoot flaming basketballs. the game has a great sense of humor about it all that makes it an absolute blast to play. NBA Jam was everything Arch Rivals was, and then some. Gameplay was faster and smoother, graphics were more detailed, and of course now they had the NBA license, so you could play as your favorite NBA All-Stars.
Well, two of them per team, that is. I think the biggest shock came when players realized Michael Jordan wasn't playable on the Bulls. Instead, you get Scottie Pippen and Horace Grant. See, Jordan actually owned the rights to his own name and likeness instead of the NBA, so he had final say in where he appeared, and it was a no to NBA Jam, and a yes to Chaos in the Windy City in 1994. There's still a good number of famous NBA stars of the day, though, like Shaq, Charles Barkley, and Patrick Ewing, among many others.
To that point, it has to be said that by the time the home console jams were in the works, the NBA had also lost the rights to represent Shaquille O'Neal, which he used to make Shaq Fu in 1994. In the Genesis and Super Nintendo ports, Shaq was replaced by Nick Anderson. There were a handful of other roster changes for the home conversion, due mainly to Home Jam working off the 1994 NBA rosters, which saw 12 roster changes on top of losing Shaq, including Detlef Schrempf's move from the Pacers to the Supersonics. In early March 1994, NBA Jam was released to home consoles on the Super Nintendo and Genesis by Acclaim, with Iguana behind the actual development.
Roster changes were really the only changes made bringing the NBA Jam magic into the home console market. Of course, there's going to be a drop in graphic and audio fidelity. The player sprites don't get bigger and smaller as they move around the court, for example, but the core gameplay and structure is all retained beautifully. That being said, each system does have their own quirks, if you will, and of those, I have to confess, really only one is a major issue for me.
I know what you mean. I cannot believe that the Iguana logo on the Genesis is so plain. Just look at the Super Nintendo, that background, that spotlight, the light, and the shadow.
I'm sorry, are you just stealing content from Console Wars now?
It's an homage, Joe.
Homage, yes. No, I was actually going to bring up the music.
Oh, right. That was my second guess. NBA Jam's soundtrack is insanely catchy, and it fits the game perfectly. Between the two console versions, I have to say that the Super Nintendo has the stronger performance here in terms of clarity and quality. But at the same time, the Genesis tracks may be more distinctive and sound more similar to the arcade.
I agree, but the really confusing thing, and my biggest complaint with the Super NES game, is that there's no music playing during the game. There's music everywhere else, but nothing playing during actual gameplay on the SNES. What gives? The Genesis is playing music during the game, and the Super Nintendo definitely could have handled it. It just makes no sense why they decide to leave it out.
It's a really bizarre choice, one I can only hope they remedied in Tournament Edition. I'd have to agree with you though, that's probably the biggest offense that the Super Nintendo makes compared to the Genesis. Strangely, there's also a couple of voice samples that were left out, most notably the Welcome to NBA Jam at the title screen. Not sure what the Super Nintendo dev team had against music and sound. Everything else is nearly identical between the two, with only slight advantages either way. For example, the colors, especially on the court, appear brighter on the Super Nintendo and more muted on the Genesis.
One last thing before we close out the Genesis and SNES discussion here. You might remember the Phoenix Suns consisting of Dan Majerle and Kevin Johnson, but others of you might think of the team differently, perhaps as Charles Barkley and Kevin Johnson. Well, in either case, you'd be right. The original home console port was indeed Barkley and Johnson. It wasn't until later, when Accolade acquired the rights to Barkley's name and likeness, that additional print runs changed the roster, substituting Majerle for Barkley. Barkley, of course, went to put his name on Barkley, Shut Up and Jam.
Lastly, NBA Jam received a slightly updated version ported to the Sega CD. It boasted an updated roster right here on the cover, and with the power of optical media behind it, we're definitely in store for greatness. Right? Well, the cover does not lie. The roster was massively updated from the other home console jams, with 21 changes by my count, including Chuck Person, who was traded off for the 94 season, moving from the Timberwolves to the Spurs, and the roster's updated to reflect this.
So everything looks identical to its cartridge counterpart, but this being a Sega CD game, I imagine we'd get some FMV or an enhanced soundtrack?
Of course!
NBA Jam Halftime Report! Altitude with an attitude!
not to mention better quality voice samples and more of them. For example, the Tonight's Match announcement is a great bit from the arcade that never made it into any of the other versions.
Tonight's matchup,
Cavaliers versus Mavericks.
Of course, the music is the star here, and it's really, really fantastic. It's probably the best of any version, including the arcade. Take a listen to this.
It even gives you the option to shut off the in-game music if you kind of liked that feature from the Super Nintendo for some reason. The failing of the Sega CD version, though, is really only because of its loading times. It just kills the momentum of this fast-paced game. For my money, even with all the extra stuff, the Sega CD version is an easy pass.
Whoa. Before we get that far, we at least have to talk about the hidden characters, which, if that's something you're into, you'll really want to consider checking this version out. The Sega CD game has a whopping 28 hidden characters you can play as. Like, for example, you can be a T-Rex. I mean, what more do you need? The Sega CD might be a little cumbersome with its loading times, but killer music, an updated roster, and some nice extras make this a great contender.
And that is NBA Jam, arcade and console. Even with all the positives, I think we can discount the Sega CD version right off of the bat. It plays just fine, of course, but the loading times kill what should be a quick pick-up-and-play kind of game. Despite it giving us the best soundtrack of all the original jams and secret characters out the ears, sadly we'll have to say goodbye to NBA Jam CD.
So we're left with the classic conundrum, Super Nintendo or Sega Genesis. Now, for my part, I think they're both pretty uniform across the board, but I just can't get over the lack of music during a game on the Super Nintendo. I mean, can you?
It is really weird, and no, you're absolutely right. The Super Nintendo might give better quality music where there is music, but having no music during the game is just inexcusable. I'm with you, Joe. My vote here goes to the Sega Genesis.
Now, we're talking about console versions, of course, but we both think that the gold standard is the arcade version. So seek that out if you have a chance. It is truly the ultimate jam experience. The ultimate jam experience, if you will. And speaking of arcade cabinets, did you know, Eric, that NBA Jam Tournament Edition hit arcade floors before the release of the console ports of the original jam?
That's right, I love trivia bits like that. Now, if you're enjoying all the NBA Jam talk and want more, you'll definitely want to stick around, because in part two, Joe and I talk all about Tournament Edition. So check out that link to Joe's channel to keep this NBA Jam spectacular rolling on. Now, before we go, I just have to say thanks, Joe, for all your help. It's really nice to be able to dive into this with a brother in arms, or dare I say it, a friend.
Yep, okay, thank you. That's adequate. It's not a problem. Just don't get weird about it, you creep.
Hey! I do the insulting around here. I'll kill you!
Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching, and I really do hope that you decide to continue on to check out part 2 over on Joe's channel. There's a link right there for you to make the jump, and if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to both of our channels if you like what you see. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you next time.